Senator Wiener, you recently introduced legislation to try to help combat this housing crisis that you've not only faced in your district, but cities all across the state are dealing with this right now. And it's really an expansion of legislation that you got passed back in 2017. The bill right now, SB 423, before we sort of get into the arguments, the pros, and some of the pushback you're getting right now, give me your elevator pitch. Why does California need this?
Well, California has a massive shortage of new homes. When you look at all 50 states and you look at the number of homes for the entire state compared to our population, homes per capita, we rank 49 out of 50. We're short millions of homes, and you can see the results, the explosive cost of housing, and it's no longer just in places like San Francisco or Berkeley. It's everywhere, and it's pushing out middle class and working families. It's pushing poor people into poverty. It's signaling to our young people that there's no future for them in the state. It's pushing people into long commutes, increasing carbon emissions, pushing people to live further and further out in wildfire zones. It's just destructive in so many ways. So we need to make it easier and faster to build new housing at all income levels, from low-income housing to market-rate housing to in-law units, student housing, senior housing, everything. And that's what we're trying to do, make it easier and faster to get housing created for our residents.
All right, so your proposed legislation received a little bit of pushback from a former assembly member who now heads Cal Labor Fed, Lorena Gonzalez Fletcher, and she tweeted this on February 22nd. Please tell me the last time a bill that redlined labor standards out of existing law was passed in California. Well, Scott Wiener and Buffy Wicks, your colleague in the assembly, apparently think it's time to try. Why? Because they want developers to be more incentivized to build market rate housing. What do you say to that?
Well, Lorena Gonzalez is a friend. We work together all the time in the assembly. We don't agree 100% of the time, but we're very aligned on a lot of issues. And she now is the head of the California Labor Federation, which is the umbrella organization for labor unions in California. I have a lifetime 99% voting record with the Labor Federation, including 100% last year, where I was classified as a quote unquote labor champion. I will stack my labor record up against pretty much anyone, and it is a pro-labor, pro-worker record. In addition, our bill is supported by the Carpenters Union, and a related bill with the same labor language is supported by the Carpenters Union, SEIU, and the School Employees Association. And I just don't agree with her to say that this is redlining out labor protections as if we're putting no labor protections in the bill. This is replacing one set of labor protections with a different, more expansive set of labor protections. And the labor protections that we're putting in the bill will lift up both union construction workers and non-unionized construction workers. 91% of residential construction workers in California are not unionized. We want to lift all of them up by requiring all of them to receive prevailing wage, health care, and protections against wage theft. So I just don't agree with her. This is somehow reducing or eliminating labor protections. It's replacing labor protections with, I think, better and more expansive labor protections.
All right, so anytime you want to talk about building in the state of California, the topic of CEQA comes up. This is the Ronald Reagan law passed more than 50 years ago, the California Environmental Quality Act, as the name says, intended to protect the environment, but it's sort of been weaponized in a way. And during a hearing this past week, you had this to say about CEQA. Can we roll it, guys?
College students, according to the court, are pollution, and so they have to be mitigated as if they were like tailpipe, like exhaust, or like fumes from a refinery. That's literally how the California Court of Appeal classified college students who are just trying to get an education at UC Berkeley and be part of the middle class, and yet they're pollution. That's how far CEQA has fallen from what it was intended to do, which was to actually protect the environment. And so we're doing some work on that, and CEQA has to be fixed.
Okay, so in your opinion, how does CEQA have to be fixed?
Well, I'm an ardent environmentalist. Climate change is an existential threat to our planet. We need to protect our natural spaces. We want clean air, clean water. So many of us agree on that. And CEQA, which has the word environmental in the law, so it's often described as an environmental law. And in some respects, it is. There are some important things that CEQA does to make sure we're not, putting all sorts of highly polluting industrial or oil refinery uses into people's neighborhoods and so on and so forth. But CEQA has been, as you put it, weaponized often by NIMBYs who don't want new housing or bike lanes or bus lines in their neighborhood. And again, they're entitled to have that opinion, but they should not be allowed, we should not allow them to use an environmental law to stop environmentally sustainable development. CEQA has been used to like slow down or kill apartment buildings right next to a train station, which is exactly where we should be building apartment buildings from a climate perspective. It's been used to oppose and slow down new bike lanes, new public transportation, clean energy. It has been weaponized. And here we have the California Court of Appeal is allowing NIMBYs to use CEQA to stop 1,100 units of student housing at UC Berkeley, on-campus housing. Now, we need student housing as an aside. We have huge problems at UC, CSU, and community colleges with student homelessness, and we need a ton of new student housing. And that's great that UC Berkeley wants to build 1,100 units. That's amazing. And the court is allowing NIMBYs to abuse environmental law to stop it. And in doing so, the Court of Appeal ruled that students are pollution, that because students are known to make noise, we're all students at some point, or human beings make noise. Human beings of all age. There are older people who also make noise, who talk loud, who have parties, who play music. But that students are apparently now pollution because they're sometimes noisy, and they've classified that as an environmental impact under an environmental law. That's absurd. We're not talking about noise like massive deafening noise from a new factory or something. This is about people, human beings talking or socializing or playing music. So it's an absurd ruling, and it is now going to empower NIMBYs up and down the state to argue that, well, if you put these new residents in, they're going to make noise, and that's an environmental problem. So we're formulating legislation to make sure that that does not happen.
Well, and I want to just ask another question about reforming CEQA, because if there's a political will, we know things can get done. And this is bipartisan, too. And this is something that governors, Governor Gavin Newsom obviously having some tough comments about it this past week, Governor Jerry Brown as well. Republicans have talked about reforming CEQA. It just seems if everybody wants to get together and do something about it, they can.
Absolutely. There are certain issues. Housing is one of them, and CEQA is another, where there is now bipartisan support. Not universal support. These are hard bills, but there are Democrats and Republicans who have common ground. And I've already spoken to a number of my colleagues, including some very left-wing Democrats and some conservative Republicans, where we have a lot of disagreements on a lot of issues. But on this, we agree that, first of all, Berkeley should be allowed to put student housing on campus, but also that CEQA is being abused and we need to make some changes to it. So my hope is that we're going to have a bipartisan, bicameral, both Assembly and Senate, effort to try to make some common sense changes to make sure that CEQA is a pro-environmental law, not an NIMBY law, and also that CEQA helps us fight climate change. Putting student housing on campus is one of the most climate-friendly things you can do, because those students are probably not going to have a car. They're going to walk to school, walk to eat, walk to the library. They'll be able to walk everywhere or take a bus. And why would we want to make them live further away from campus where they might drive more?
All right, we will leave it there. Senator Scott Wiener, we thank you for your time, as always, on Inside California Politics.
Thank you so much.